Let's take a look at something called the attribute parent of the PI TreeView. So I'm going to go ahead and modify this TreeView. And you'll notice that among the different things that we can configure is something called attribute parents. Okay. Now let me explain what we mean by attribute parents. Attribute parents allows us to specify what attributes in AF we're going to allow you to connect to and pass to a receiving web part through web part connections. So we, by default, when we connect web parts, we allow certain things to be passed from the tree view, for example, to other web parts. With attribute parents, you can specify exactly which AF attributes you can add in addition to the defaults. Now, I would fully expect that that doesn't make sense to 90% of the people watching this, you know, just right off the top, because it's a very arcane construction, to be honest. It's certainly not real intuitive, but it's very powerful. And of course, you know, whenever you hear the word powerful with computers, it usually means it's very difficult to configure, and this is no exception. This is fairly tricky to configure. A lot of things you got to keep in mind here. So let's go through this slowly and look piece by piece what we're talking about here. Let's say that I would like to have, with this tree view, I would like to have a connection to another web part, oh, let's say a PI graphic web part, such that as I choose, let me get out of edit mode here, as I choose one tank after another, each time I choose a tank, it drives a different SVG file over to that graphic web part. We essentially would like to have some attribute buried in this element here that specifies the name of an SVG and then pass that over to the graphic web part over here. Well, let's see how we would go about doing that. First of all, let's add the graphic web part. I'll go ahead and add a web part to here. So we'll have this on the left and this in the body. I'm going to add the PI graphic web part. There it is. Okay, I just chose to add it, and it should show up, and it's going to be configured to show nothing at this point. Now, believe me, if you're interested, if you don't know anything about connections and web parts, there's a lot more to be said about this in our RT web parts CBT, if you're interested. But in this case, we're just going to do just some real brief connections here, just to show you how this works. So what I'd like is to have something configured here so that it drives this PI graphic. So what I would probably want to do then is add something to this element template here, add something to this element template that adds a reference to an SVG file. So let me show you what we have to work with towards that end. See, when we configure this PI graphic, we have to specify a file, an SVG file. In fact, if I go out and browse here, you'll notice that we do have some SVG files already. These are in the shared documents here. It's in a document library in SharePoint here. And so what I can do is I would like to have something that adds those as part, as an attribute of an element, you know, over in this hierarchy here, such that when I click on one of these, it passes that URL or that path over to here and then configures it. And we'll do that via a web part connection. The first thing to do then is to go into the PI System Explorer and add the URLs that would, or add the paths to those SVG files. Now I know if I go into this shared documents here, I can go ahead and find those. Yeah, there are our SVG files. And let me just copy these one at a time. I'm going to copy that shortcut. That's a shortcut to an SVG. If you look down at the bottom, you can see those are SVG files. So I want to copy this in a way that everybody in the company has access to it. So that's centrally located. And now I want to add these as attributes to these elements here. Let me go ahead and get rid of this so we can see more of that. Yeah, I want to add a brand new attribute here called, oh, let's just call it MySVG. And MySVG is going to be a path. So I could just do new element right now. Oops, I could choose to do a new element right now. But I think instead of doing a new element or a new attribute right here, I think I'll be a little bit smarter and do this as an addition to these templates. Okay, so what we have here is we've got these three different, these are three different element templates. Each of these element templates, if we take a look at those, yeah, see, this is this first tank is Tank Charlie as a template. That's Tank Alpha and Tank Bravo. I would like to add a kind of a generic tank and then make that generic tank organized such that all of these element templates are going to inherit what's in that generic tank. So let's do this. I'll choose a new template. I'll call this template, let's call this generic tank. And in this generic tank, I'm going to add an attribute. This is where we're going to add. It's just going to be called MySVG. Now that doesn't do any, that doesn't accomplish anything yet. Because if you notice, if we go over to these elements here, those elements, they don't have MySVG. Well, why don't they have that? Because we haven't really linked these together. I'm going to go ahead and link these together now. I'll go into the Tank Alpha, and I'm going to make the generic tank a base template for Tank Alpha. I'll do that for Tank Bravo and Tank Charlie. So all of these are now using this generic tank as its base template. I'll go ahead and check that in. And this kind of shows you, I guess I want to take the opportunity yet again to show you the value of doing templates. If I go now into my list of elements, no big surprise here. Let me go ahead and refresh my screen. All of a sudden, all of these now have this new field called MySVG. And who can guess what mistake I made? Well, MySVG, that's not supposed to be a double. I forgot to configure the element template or the attribute template properly. But hey, that's no problem. I'll claim that that was on purpose so that I could demonstrate the power of doing templates. I'll just make that change over here. I'll call that a string instead of a double. I'll check that in. There we go. And just as I had planned from the beginning, now you can see the value of that because, see, now these are all showing up as strings. So there's my SVG. And looks like we're real close, right? We're actually not, but it looks like we're close. So what happens? Let's see if I can start pasting these SVGs. Remember I did that copy? Now I'm going to paste that. That's my reference to my one SVG. That's going to be in the first one. Let's go back and find the other. I'll do a copy from here. Paste the second one there. There's the third one. Copy the last one. And then paste the last one. So there we go. So now it looks like I've got something here that should work, right? I've got this new MySVG. Each one, take a look at that right there, and you'll notice each one changes. So it should be real simple now. All I need to do is make a link that will link my my TreeView to the PI graphic. So let's see if that will work. Let me go back to my TreeView example. And we'll go ahead and configure a link. When we configure these connections, we have to be in build mode to do that. Let me switch over to edit page. Yeah, when we configure these connections, and again, this is beyond the scope of this class, really, but what I just want to demonstrate briefly, what I'm doing is I'm sending these client-side parameters to the PI graphic. And that establishes the connection between the two graphics. But I still need to specify where within this PI graphic web part we're going to receive that. Now the logical destination for this is going to be right here, because that's going to be, that specifies the name of the file that we're going to be displaying. Well, I can do this using a connection. And here's the problem. Take a look at the things that I'm allowed to pass. I'm allowed to pass a list of tags, which is great. You can see that comes in real handy. We'll talk about that when we do the element relative displays. We can also pass the element relative path, and again, that's very useful. But where's my SVG? I don't see my SVG here. Well, we don't see my SVG, and there's a solution to that. We don't see it because we haven't instructed the TreeView control to treat or to include that MySVG as one of the things it passes in WebPart connections. The way we would do this is we would edit the tree view control. We would go into the attribute parents, and this is where it gets, well, I think fairly cool. Watch what happens. Once I specify in this attribute parents here that we're going to choose, let's just choose, we don't have to choose all of them, just one of these as its attribute parent, then all of the attributes that are organized underneath that element will become available to pass as a Webpart connection or through Webpart connections. So all I need to do here is go out here to attribute parents. I need to find the right structure. This is under solution tank farm. Yeah, here they are. Doesn't matter which one I pick. Really doesn't matter. I'll just choose, because if you remember, all of these tanks have that attribute. I'll go ahead and add that. And the big finish to this is, I'll kind of spoil the big finish. Even before you do the big finish, once you apply, what you'll notice is that, watch the before and after of our filter values. Yeah, we're not going to be covering filter values in this class, but once I specify that as an attribute parent, look how long this list gets. That's because now these are all valid things that I can pass, including my SVG. So let's go to the real big finish here. The real big finish is to go out to this PI graphic. We're going to specify what attribute contains the selected file. And for that, I'll go into connections. I will again specify TreeView. As you can see, we actually have now, through that attribute parents, we've identified all the different attributes that are available, including the one I just configured. I'll go ahead and specify that. I'll go ahead and click on OK. Once we exit out of edit mode, what we should be able to demonstrate is, as I switch from one display to the next, we'll go ahead and retrieve different SVG files. So if I click here, that's one SVG. Click here, different SVG, a third. It's basically all those different SVG files that we had configured. And the reason we're able to pass them now is because we've modified the attribute parents field in the tree view definition. Remember, this is done over here in the tree view definition. We're defining through attribute parents, you know, all the attributes associated with this element are available. Now, as you can see, you could have specified more than one element. There's absolutely nothing wrong with cherry picking all throughout your AF structure, you know, picking up a couple of attributes here, a couple of attributes there, and making all of them available for this tree view to be able to pass using this Webpart connections. If you're curious what some of these others do, like what this connection is right here in the query string parameter, we're going to discuss that. I think it's two videos for now when we discuss query strings and passing them via the URL.